Hey, what's going on, folks? So we're sitting up in the house today. I've got the boat up in the shop right now, unfortunately, having some work done on it. I think we're having some electrical issues now. Just old motor working through some stuff. So what I figured I would do today, since I don't have any tournament videos or anything coming out, is go ahead and make another rigging video. So what I wanted to talk about today is sort of my approach to, and I think I'm going to do a couple of these. My absolute favorite bait, and I started when I really started throwing conventional gear more. I grew up in the fly fishing in the industry. I've always enjoyed flies in the fly fishing industry that fish a lot like jigs, whether it be crayfish imitations, leech imitations, helgramites, things like that. Something that has that jigging action, I think is just, it's hard to beat. So when I started fishing a lot more conventional gear, jigs were kind of just a natural thing for me to pick up. And so I want to do a few videos on jigs. Today in particular, I want to talk about swim jigs. Before we dive into it though, if you guys enjoyed this video, please consider hitting that subscribe button down below. Hit the little notification bell that's next to it as well. That way, whenever I post new videos, you'll get an update. It's a great way to support the channel. And it also makes sure that you don't miss videos that I post. And as always, leave a like and a comment. So what I wanted to do today, since we're kind of in that fall transition period or moving into it, you know, late summer and fall, bass are going to really start focusing on bait fish even more heavily. Of course, bluegill are always going to play through the fall. If you are in a lake that has a lot of grass, obviously the frog bite gets really good this time of year. But for us here on Kentucky and Barkley Lake, really the bait fish is the key. And right now we have millions and millions of little threadfin shad. They're, you know, 2 inches long, 2.5 inches long tops. All sorts of little shiners, things like that. So a great way to fish for these is with a swim jig. So today, we're gonna just talk about the swim jig. And to start out, I'm gonna go ahead and just talk about the rod setup. So there's a few different thoughts on this. I personally like to fish on a little bit of a softer action rod. The way that I go when I'm fishing a swim jig is actually, this is a 7'3". I don't like to go super long on these rods because I fish them around docks and a lot of shallow cover. So you can go shorter, like a 7-footer. I like that 7'3" being a short person myself. This helps me, I feel like, you know, with just getting a little more leverage on these fish. So this is 7'3" is just a good length for me. You'll figure it out for yourself. But I actually throw a medium action rod. I don't throw very heavy swim jigs, you know, especially when you're talking about bait fish. They are up near the surface of the water, especially this time of year. You don't have to fish crazy heavy swim jigs. So I throw a medium. And the reason I do this is I actually want this rod to have a little bit more of that parabolic action, a deeper bend into the blank. So that way I don't actually rip the bait out of these fish. One of the issues that you have with the swim jig is a fish will come up and roll on it and eat it. And if you are too quick on that draw, they won't get it sometimes. At least for me, that's something that I've struggled with. I used to throw it on a 7'3" medium heavy. And I had a lot of issues with pulling the bait out of fish when I would set the hook, breaking line. Like I was breaking 40 and 50 pound braid on my hook sets with every braid that I used. So what I did is I switched up, went to this medium action. It's got a lot softer tip, a lot deeper bend into the rod. It seems to load up a lot better for me. And I really don't, for some reason, I just don't swing as hard with it. So that's what I prefer. You can use whatever speed reel you like. This is just a 6.6:1. The reason I like that is it's got a little bit more power in it, I feel like, than, you know, like a super high-end or high-speed reel, like an 8.1:1. Most of the time, I am not needing to move it much faster than what I do with that 6.6:1. And then you can throw it on whatever line that you really prefer. I prefer an 8-strand. Braid. I don't remember what line's on this rod right now. I've been switching a lot of braid out right now and trying to play around with some different stuff. But anyways, 30 to 50 pound braid. If it's gin clear water, I might throw fluorocarbon, and I'm going to throw 20 pound fluoro. That's the only time that I'm going to throw fluoro though, is if it's absolutely gin clear. Otherwise, I'm throwing braid. Especially around in our lakes, you know, we get a lot of algae in the fall. You usually get some sort of late turnover. And the reality is you just don't have to throw anything other than braid. Also, if you're around grass, you don't want to throw mono. Regardless of how clear it is, just throw the braid. The fish are not going to be that scared of it. Besides, with the swim jig, you're moving it quick. They're not going to have a lot of time. This is a lot more about triggering a reaction bite and putting something in front of those fish over and over and over again. A lot of times this year, because there's so much bait, repetition is key. And I really prefer throwing the swim jig a lot this time of year around shallow wood, back in stake beds, on old road beds that the bait fish are congregating on top of, you know, brush piles, all that stuff. And I'm trying to put that bait over it over and over and over and over again, because just because a bass is sitting in there, if there is, you know, a couple thousand shad that are all around it, it might take a couple casts to get them to actually move on yours when they're eating all sorts of other dying bait around them from them busting up a school of shad. So lots of repetition. They aren't going to worry about the line that much. Okay, so moving into the baits, we're going to bust out the old jig box here. And I try to keep it pretty simple with jigs. So I keep one jig box in the boat year round for all my stuff. And so usually, most of the year, I prefer to throw a 3/8 ounce. This is just, real simple, a pearl skirt, white head, 3/8 ounce. You can see it's got a pretty chunky hook in there. Most of the year, what I'm doing is I'm throwing a big profile swim jig, trying to capitalize on fish that are eating big thread fin or those smaller class of gizzard shad. So when I put a bait on the back of this, whether it's a swim bait or some sort of chunk style trailer, this actually ends up being a really big profile. So this time of year, because we've got small bait, I like to mix it up and I will do something a little bit different. So what I've got right here is my full kind of presentation. This is a little bit lighter head, little bit smaller head, and you see that hook is a little bit shorter. And now what I will actually do, shoot, I didn't bring a pair of scissors over here with me to show you this. What I will do on a bait like this is I will go ahead and cut this skirt up in order to make that a more compact trailer size. Tell you what, hold on one sec. I'm gonna go grab a pair of scissors. Okay, here we go. Got a pair of scissors again. So I'll just show you guys. What I will do is I will come and I want to take this up to maybe, you'll have to play with it and see what looks best depending on your style trailer that you're going to run. But I'm going to want to take this up to right about there. So my hook is here. I'm going to come in and just cut this straight. My wife is going to love having all this rubber in the living room. You know, to clean that up later. But basically, you see, I've got a really tight skirt here, and if you need to even more, you can start pulling these strands out, and what that's going to do is slim that profile down and give it a nice tight profile. Okay, and then really I throw two different styles of trailers. My number one style this time of year is going to be just a little boot tail, and this is actually the Reaction Innovations little dipper. I love this one. I guess the color here is white trash. I love these baits. They're a little bit stiffer. They hold up pretty well. And what I will do when I'm rigging these up, because they've got that taper on the front there, so I will come in usually and just cut that flat. And then what we're going to do here, as always, take your swim bait, line it up, see where that hook needs to come out on the bait, okay? And I will mark it with my thumb and my ring finger like that. What this allows me to do is hold that bait in four fingers like this and keep it nice and straight. I'm going to run that hook up into the bait. Boom. Pop that out. And you can put a little dab of super glue on here or something. And it's crucial with this that you get that bait to line up as straight as you can with your jig head. And so what you end up with here, and of course you could cut this down a little bit more and make this as compact of a swim bait trailer as you want, but you can see that's a nice stiff swim bait that I can slow roll and give it the occasional pop over like a brush pile or a stake bed. But you can see that's a pretty good, I mean, compared to my hand, that's a pretty compact little pattern, especially if you take this trailer up and, you know, cut this down a little bit more. so your hook is coming out back here, you can really make this thing pretty tight. This, I think, really the big issue is the skirt. I still like having that length because if I can, I want them to have a good size profile. I think that it's going to weed out a lot of the small fish that you catch this time of year. If you've got a profile that's, you know, whatever that is, I guess about 3.5 inches long or so. There's a lot of, you know, gizzard shad and stuff in the lake that'll be in that size range. And it stands out a little bit from sort of its peers out there in the water. But I don't want to go with a full size, like big, huge swim bait. So I'm going to give you an example. I actually have one here with my other style of trailer rigged up. And this is if we get some fall rain and if things are real dirty, or for some reason we get around a bunch of gizzard shad. And I want to show you the difference in these profiles, okay? So this is what we just rigged up. This is my standard with that little swim bait, okay? Then we've got my other kind of dirty water or real big fish or real shallow water presentation here around like flooded bushes. And this is usually what I'll throw in the springtime. So the bait that I throw on the back of these is just the baby packacraw that Netbait makes. Throw it in that white color a lot of the time, pearl. So this is a 3¾-inch trailer on its own. And then I will throw it on that jig. So if you look at these, the length here is not too dissimilar, okay? Similar lengths. But if you look at that profile size, this is massive compared to this guy, right? This is a much better representation of the bait that's in the water right now than a massive swim jig like this. So for this time of year, as we're moving into fall, September, October, November, start throwing around those smaller, more compact skirts, little boot tail on there. You can throw, you know, like a Strike King Rage Swimmer, I think is what they're called on the back. Those are great little swim baits. They're very soft. They've got lots of movement. I will start throwing a Kitech on a swim jig once we get into the winter time. I throw a swim jig all year. I always have a swim jig tied on, at least one of them in the boat. But for now, so that way I can keep it moving really quick. The advantage to having a real firm boot tail, like this little, or the skinny dipper, I guess, from Little Dipper, yeah, the Little Dipper from Reaction Innovations. What it does is it allows me to move this bait really, really fast without having it blow out. What you'll notice if you fish a really soft swim bait, like a Kitech, it will tend not to ride as well through the water. Some of this is dependent on your swim jig head, the way that you trim your skirt, the way that you rig your plastic. If you don't rig it straight and you don't rig it up perfectly in line with that head from both directions, you know, you're gonna have blowouts. This isn't gonna swim right. But by and large, this is the bait that I'm gonna throw. It doesn't kick out. You don't have blowouts. It tracks very straight, whether you're, you know, boiling it right on the surface almost, like you would, you know, with spinner baits, or if you're rolling it down a little bit deeper, fishing for some of those fish that are sitting just off a little bit and, you know, kind of that 8 to 12 foot range on brush piles moving back into the creek mouths, this is a good way to fish. Sorry about my phone there, guys. But anyways, the swim jig, this is it. That's what I throw. I've always got them on my deck. You guys have seen me fish them a lot in a lot of my other videos. Pair that up with your 7.3 medium action rod, 30 to 50 pound braid. I'm throwing 40 on this one right now. 6.6-1 reel and go catch them. It's a pretty foolproof way of fishing. I mean, you cannot fish it wrong. Slow wind it around, burn it on top, give it little pops. And just the main thing this time of year, pick isolated structure. Isolated docks, laydowns, stump fields, rock piles, brush piles, or stake beds if you've got them in your lake. All that stuff is gonna start holding fish. And really what I've found for me, the best way to catch them this time of year is to just run as much of that stuff as I can. And eventually you're going to find those better sized fish. It's just a matter of if you can get around to them. So that's what I like to do. Appreciate you guys watching today and see you on the next one. All right. Tight lines, everybody.